Again, another bloody Friday working as an errand boy. I suppose they're too important over at Wake Publishers to come looking for jolly old Husher themselves. Shit. Even I should be too important for that. Though I mustn't overstretch my complaints. Rising from my lot as a drunkard and financial ruin to that of an errand boy is actually quite an improvement. If only things had gone a bit better for the company, or I'd got on the wagon a bit sooner. Damn, Sophie did the right thing when she divorced me. I would have divorced myself in her place. Daniel Neuer, the bloody alcoholic. Chin up, you. That is Daniel Neuer, the bloody ex-alcoholic, after all. Wake Publishers employee by day, Wake Publishers screwed over lackey by evening. Even Friday evenings. But if I could find Husher, I have a feeling my status at the company would rise quite a bit. After all, he is the publishing firm's biggest star. Well, let's cross our fingers and hope he's home.
Hello?
Is that music? I'd better take a look. Is that someone playing a music box? There's something on that doorknob. Interesting. What the? How can there be a door there? Thank you. hardly taken a step forward when I heard the door close behind me. When I turned around, the door wasn't there anymore. And all that was left of it was a strange shadow on the wall. I searched. I despaired. And I screamed until my throat began to burn. The candles started to run out, as did the batteries in my torch. From within the most suffocating darkness, the hours went by until turning into days, and I began to fall in and out of a restless sleep. I would hear voices, sometimes right next to me, other times a few yards away. It seemed like they were coming from the other side of the wall. Desperate cries, howling in horror, and sometimes, the worst of all, a vast, oppressive silence would fall, seeming to emanate from everywhere and nowhere all at once. There was nobody there, just hallucinations, nightmares, black nothingness, and the song from that music box. Trapped in this impossible place, I wondered if I was going to die there.
Etienne, do you have any news on Daniel yet?
Oh, Sophie. No. We've been calling him at home all day, but there's no response. Do you know if he's got a mobile phone?
No, I don't think so. And if he does, he doesn't tend to keep it on him.
Oh, man. I think I should pass by the Husher place when I leave, just to see if they know anything.
Husher the writer? Your client?
Yeah. I sent Daniel over there on Friday, and I haven't heard from him since.
What's the address? I'm going to stop by Daniel's place, and if I don't find him, I can go around and ask about him.
The house in the outskirts of town, on Highway EB-15. Number 4, Abbott Thomas Road. It's a big house.
Okay. I'm headed over. Call me if you find him.
Of course. Same to you.
The door was open. Is there anybody home? There's something on the counter. Yes. What was that? I didn't hear anything. Thank you. Yes. Phone. Should I answer? Hello? Sorry, who is this? I can't understand you.
We can't leave my room.
What the? It sounded like a child. Is he in the house? Daniel, is that you? Pushing that door. this. That room looks really dark. Is there someone on the other side? I have to get in there. Yes. There's a note stuck on the safe. Yes. Finally. Daniel, if you're here, I'm going to find you. Please. Was that for real, or am I imagining things?
Huh. Mm-mm.
Mommy's really scared. I'm scared too. She's broken all the mirrors in the house. And that song? I hear it everywhere. I wish we'd never listened to it. Something is watching us.
That toilet stinks.
Yeah.
God, everything is normal again. Just find the hiding place. No hiding places here. Get moving.
Thank you.
hell is going on?
Sebastian. We've seen their children grow since they were babies. I don't understand this sudden change in attitude. I saw her playing and reading with the children in the living room last night. They looked exhausted. I could hear it in their voices, but they wouldn't go to sleep. They seemed to be avoiding it at all costs. I had a terrible nightmare last night. Something was lurking in the house, but in my attempt to escape, I couldn't find the main door. It was as if it didn't exist, or as if I couldn't make it to the entrance hall. The strangest thing is that I don't remember waking up.
God, I got it shut.